All right. Hey, Josh, we're back again. I think this is the last one that you and I are doing. After this, you get to go have fun with other Java people at Microsoft and not me. So I think you're going to have a lot of fun there and people that speak your language a little more. So today is Cosmos DB with Spring.
Yep.
Right. In particular, you're going to go not necessarily straight Cosmos route, but Mongo, the Mongo interface to Cosmos, right?
Yep, and it works perfectly. And that's one of the nice things about Cosmos DB is that in addition to having been built from the ground up to support global distribution and horizontal scale and to guarantee single digit millisecond read and write latencies at the 99th percentile, all that good stuff. In addition to guaranteeing 99.9999% high availability with multi-homing anywhere in the world, it also speaks a whole bunch of different protocols. So if you want to consume it as a MongoDB, you can. If you want to consume it as a Cassandra, you can. If you want to speak to it using the Gremlin protocol, which is a graph database, you can. And if you want to speak to it using a SQL syntax and protocol, again, you can, which is phenomenal, right? Really, really impressive piece of kit. So we're just going to write a Spring Data MongoDB application. There is absolutely nothing fantastic about this at all. In fact, I'm not even going to use a Azure. There's no Spring Azure starter here for this. I'm just going to use a regular Spring Data MongoDB project to talk to Cosmos DB. Simple as that, right? Magic is not a great word, but it's pretty appropriate in this case. So Cosmos DB. All right, I'm going to use that. And then the application is going to be Spring Data. And you can see we've got a lot of Spring Data projects here, right? So Spring Data for Apache Cassandra. I could have used that. That would have worked. But MongoDB is by far the most prolific of all the NoSQL data stores. That's it, right? By the way, I could use Reactive MongoDB or I could use MongoDB. So Reactive APIs give us the ability to write code that doesn't block. It doesn't sit on a thread waiting for things to happen. As soon as there's an opportunity, it jumps off of the thread so that something else can use it. I'm going to hit Generate, and we're going to open this up. Here we go. Now I've got... Let's see here. What happened here? Close that. Here's my Cosmos DB instance. Good. I've got in my portal here. I've got my Azure Cosmos DB. Come on, tile. Okay, click on that, and I've got a Cosmos DB instance, and in there, I've got the actual data, right? And there's even a data explorer. You can see the connection strings. Connection string information. I'm not going to show you that because, of course, it's private. But once you've got that information, you can then plug it into your MongoDB connection string. And what you're going to do is you're going to connect to a collection. A collection is it's like a MongoDB collection which has rows which are called documents. So it actually maps very nicely. And I'm going to go to the collection here, the data explorer, and I've got my data. I've got actually the records here. In my collection. So there you go. You can see I've already got a bunch of it already stored there. I can work, but for my high resolution here, there you go. Right, I've got data there. So all we're gonna do is just write some more data, I guess. We can actually delete the collection. Okay, so reservations. Okay, let's delete that. And delete this one as well. Reservation. Very, very nosy. It wants to know why I want to delete the collection. Now, we are going to build an application that uses just regular Spring Data syntax. Not a big deal here. So public static void main, as usual. We're going to create an object to map it to the domain model of our database. In this case, it'll just be an instance of type reservation that'll have a primary key or document key of type string, because again, in MongoDB and in Azure Cosmos DB, you have UUIDs. You don't have monotonically incrementing primary keys, right? So these are documents, again, maps very naturally to the domain model there, and we'll have a string of type name. That's the essence of what I want to express. That's the field plus the primary key or the data key, whatever. I want to create some getters and setters and toString and equals and hash code and all that good stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and bring in Lumbuck. Lumbuck's a compile time annotation processor. I should have, and probably would have, selected that back at the initializer, but I forgot. So we'll have to do it the old-fashioned way by manually adding the dependency to the build. All orgs constructor, no orgs constructor. Good. So there's our entity. And now we're going to create a reservation repository. Extends Mongo repository, right? So reservation, string. And now I just want to save some data into the database. So we're going to say class Cosmos DB demo. And we're just going to create a bean. It's going to be an object that gets initialized when the application starts up. I'm going to inject a reference to that repository there, and we'll just take advantage of it. We're going to say rr.save, new reservation. Pass in null and, beautiful Azure. Okay. Good. That's it, right? Find all for each. System.out print line. Good stuff. Okay. So let's run this and see. Oh, and you know, this is not going to work. And this will actually work. You know why this would work? It's very deceptive. This would work right now as I've got it, because it would connect by default to my localhost instance. And since I have a localhost MongoDB, I would actually be fooled into thinking it worked just fine. I need to point it to my cloud. So in order to do that, I need some configuration. And this is the only place where we're going to see that we've got any kind of configuration at all that indicates that we're not talking to local MongoDB. So spring.data.mongodb.database equals bootiful Cosmos DB. And spring.data.mongodb.uri equals, and here I've got an environment variable, right? So Azure Cosmos DB Mongo URL, right? That's it. That's the entire application. This URL could have been any valid MongoDB instance, and in this case, any Azure Cosmos DB instance, okay? All right, let's see. Run the application, see what we get. Okay, it looks like it's connecting. Open a connection, wrote out the data. So we saved the data, and we asked for all the data to come back, and we've got you can see here, it's a UUID that's been given to us by the database. And if we go back to here, just hit refresh. Data Explorer, reservation, documents. Wait for it to pull down the data remotely on my pittance of Wi-Fi.
And so the default here is when the collection wasn't there, it went and goes and creates the collection and then plops it in.
We created it for us. Yep. So no rabbits up my sleeve. I just did everything from the code there. And you can see the results reflected in the output in the console here.
So as far as your app knows, you're looking at a Mongo database. So a lot of people out there use Mongo. And now, they didn't have to go change any of their code, but they're actually being backed by Azure Cosmos DB instead.
Which is a heck of a proposition, right? I mean, You heard the numbers. That truly is web scale, right? This is the first time I can actually say that this is web scale MongoDB. This is crazy, crazy geo replication, crazy availability, crazy low latency. Just a very compelling experience. And Spring Data has support for MongoDB transactions. It's got support for all sorts of things. I think most of which, if not all of it, I'm pretty sure all of it, but don't quote me on that, is supported by Cosmos DB. It just works, which is awesome.
Yeah, and I think the cooler part of this is you're writing your Spring app, and we have a lot of Mongo customers on Azure. So if you whether you're using Mongo running on a set of IaaS VMs on Azure, or whether you're using Mongo Enterprise from Mongo, or you're using Mongo and Cosmos, a lot of customers use both for different use cases and different things. So Spring has allowed us to just say, hey, one API. And go configure the endpoint with the power of the Mongo interface to Cosmos.
Right. Works a charm. And the other thing is, I didn't even mention it, but you could do reactive MongoDB here as well, so non-blocking.
Awesome. Well, thanks, Josh, and we'll see you again soon.
Sounds good.